Hello people, welcome back to my channel. The topic for today's video is vectorization in neural networks. So in the last video we saw what was weights and biases, and we tried to represent in matrix form so that our computation becomes easier. So the basic ideology is that we just back propagate at each and every particular layer that is contained in a particular neural network, and we just go to that individual or precise unit or neuron, and then we update the weights. So this updation is basically done with the help of gradient descent. So I have covered gradient descent in separate video, so you can just check that video. I'll put the link in the description. So basically what we have is, we have this equation. So we have the output at one particular layer is represented as W, and we have the output that is L minus 1 that is from the previous layer, and then we have the bias at that particular layer. So now in this particular equation, which is of the form y is equal to mx plus c. So in the linear regression, what we had is we had the cost, that is j, that was dependent on the slope and the intercept. So here also in the similar case, we have this cost. We take j as the cost function, and it's dependent on the weight as well as the bias. So our major goal when we learn neural network, our major aim is to just update the weights and the biases which were initially assigned randomly. So we essentially are concerned with this weight and the biases inputs that we can't do anything, that we just process in particular steps, we get the resultant output of that. So we can't make any hold on this particular weight. So essentially what we want to do is we want to learn the best parameters. So the best parameters that I mean is the weight and the biases. So that's where our cost comes reduced. So essentially the cost of this particular neural network can be represented as, say you have 1 upon m, where m is a number of training examples, and y and y cap. So this is a lost function. So this is a cost function which is represented in terms of the loss function. Now if you remember, you have this linear regression, so in that also you have the similar setup. So where I is equal to 1 to m, y minus y predicted square. So where in linear regression you had this kind of equation, now here you have this kind of equation. But the problem here is, if you want to take the differentiative or if you want to perform any particular activity, you need to have this in a representation for the convex form. So how would you represent that? So you can basically write this as a combination of log loss function. So how this is expanded, so it is given as y log y cap plus 1 minus y log 1 minus y cap. So now this is a particular convex equation, which is same like the one which we have seen in the linear regression. So now this becomes differentiable. So whenever you take the gradient descent, it becomes differentiable for updation of the weight. So I'll just give a quick glance of what gradient descent is. So since our j, that is the cost, is dependent on two factors, weight and the bias, so just we'll just take one particular parameter j with respect to weight, that is j versus weight, you get a graph something like this. So basically our minimum is at this point, so where the error is zero, error is equal to zero is at this point. So our major goal is that we get the minimum error. So basically we start with that one particular point. So say we have individual points like this, and we cannot take one unit at particular iteration. So then that becomes like, if we have, say for example, we are reached at this point, and if we are taking a one unit distance, then it will just miss this particular point. So we don't want that to happen. So essentially what we take is, when we just progress towards the bottom, we take small baby steps. So whenever you start with a longer distance, you just at the each particular iteration, you will just reduce that particular length so that you converge to this particular point. So how this is known to that particular algorithm? It is learned by this parameter called as the learning rate. So how much it has to learn in each particular iteration. So this essentially can be assumed like since small kids are there, when they learn to walk in the first few months, they'll take small baby steps. So then they gradually learn to walk. So similar is the case with here. So initially you start with longer distance, then gradually as you move down, so you just reduce the slope. So say consider you have a bridge like this. So where in this case, if you consider this slope is equal to zero. So any car can move easily upon this. But say if you have a bridge something like this, then what the car does is it will take smaller accelerations and it will apply brakes and brakes and brakes, and then it will reach at this particular point. That is the same case here, but here you have a more steepness, so thereby you update the weights. So how do you change the weights, or how do you learn the weights? So that is given by this equation. So you just take the partial derivative, dou j by dou w, dou represents the partial derivative, and you have the weights, that is weight is given by weight minus alpha into dou j by dou w. Now in order to differentiate this, j has parameters in w and b so that it can be easily differentiable. So for each of the weights you need to adjust this. So say at this particular point your slope is positive and your slope is negative. So what you need to do is you need to just go down the valley. So essentially if alpha is positive and this particular slope is also positive, then you are essentially going into the downward direction. So then gradually your weight gets reduced and you converge to one particular point. Similar is the case with your bias as well. So for this you have this bi is equal to bi minus alpha into dou j by dou bi. So for each of the biases and each of the weights for your particular neural network x1 x2 x3 x4 in the previous setup we saw, we have this connections, we just build this neural network. So accordingly for each of the weights you need to adjust this. So this updation is done with the help of gradient descent, and when we move forward, what we have is a forward propagation, and for coming back to each of the layer, which is a bit difficult activity, we do back propagation. So now what I want to do is I have two graphs like this. So this is with j with respect to w and this is j with respect to b. You get similar graph, that is a two-dimensional graph. Now if I want to just club this together, so what I have is I have weight, I have bias, I have j. So in three-dimensional space I can observe that I can get a parabola like this, so which looks like a bowl shaped curve. So something like this you can observe. So from each of the dimension you can observe, like you can see this particular figure which is appearing. So that's nothing but a parabolic curve, something like this. So where your minimum is at this particular point that you try to achieve here, that is this particular point. So essentially what we do is we do the vectorization. So each and everything, so if you consider this weight equation, or if you consider the updation for the bias, so everything is considered as the vector. So say for example this weight is represented as w1 up till wn. So in terms of dimensions, it is a 1 cross n matrix, and it is given as the same. So this is the new one and this is the old weight, so that is 1 cross n. Then you multiply, so this is basic learning rate, so that you keep it as 0.1 or any particular value that is kept by the data scientist. And then you have this also, so this dou j dou w1 dou j dou w2 up till dou j dou wn. So these are also vectorized. So you can see everything in this particular equation has some or the other form. So every dimension is equivalent. So you can do the particular activity which is carried out in particular direction. So that's how we do the vectorization of neural networks, so it becomes easier for our calculation. So well, that was all regarding the vectorization of neural networks. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you got educated on this video, please do like, share, comment, and if you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching this video.